Hello, everyone. Welcome to the second installment of the This Week in Jewish History series. This week, we're commemorating a major event in medieval history, the conquest of Jerusalem by the Christian Crusaders in the year 1099. This is an event which had signal importance for the geopolitics of the era at that time, but also had lasting and incredible ramifications for future history, not only for Jews who were involved particularly in the Rhineland massacres, but also for Muslims and Christians and the new relationships that would come out of the conquest of the era. So let's jump over to the Prezi right now and let's have a look at it. We'll go full screen. Okay, so the First Crusade occurred in 1095, and basically it refers to an event when these Christian crusaders came from all over Europe, traveling primarily by boat, and then through a remarkable force of arms, pushed their way through all the way to Jerusalem, where they ultimately attacked Jerusalem, sack it, massacre the local inhabitants, most of whom are Muslims at the time, and create a new Christian era in Jerusalem. The origins of the Crusades occurred in 1095 when the Byzantine emperor, who found that his access to the holy sites of Jerusalem, that is for the Christian pilgrims who were going there, was blocked by the Shiite Muslims who had conquered the region in 1071. The Byzantine Empire, which represented Eastern Christianity, Orthodox Christianity, approached the Roman Catholic Pope and asked for his assistance in reconquering Jerusalem so that access would be allowed to the pilgrims who wanted to see those places. The Pope complied, and of course there were a lot of other motivations besides the solely religious, but he sent crusaders from all over Europe, a remarkable show of European unity, to attack Jerusalem and then create a Christian kingdom there. The Jewish connection is not so much in Jerusalem because there were very few Jews living there at the time, but there's actually a remarkably large population of Jews living in northern Germany. This map here shows you the routes that the crusaders took to get to Jerusalem. As you can see from the legend, there were actually several crusades. Some of them were more successful than others, and they had to traverse the entire northern Mediterranean basin, sometimes traveling by sea, to get to Jerusalem. While they were on their way, however, many of them stopped off in the Rhineland, in the traditional area known as Ashkenaz, the Jews, specifically the three cities known as Shum, Speyer, Worms, and Mainz, where many Jews had settled. And some of these crusaders thought, you know, why are we schlepping all the way to Jerusalem to defeat the infidel when we have non-believers right here in our own backyard? And so many of them descended on the Jewish communities that were living there in peace in the horrible year 1096 and perpetrated incredible massacres. The first of them to fall was Speyer in May of 1096, and then Worms and Mainz shortly thereafter. Speyer actually got off fairly easy because the local bishop acted with great heroism and actually forced out the crusaders and had some of their hands cut off as a warning to those who would inflict damage on the Jews. In Worms and Mainz, however, the crusaders did not heed the bishop's protection of the Jews, and in fact they even invaded the bishop's house where many of the Jews had hidden. You can see in this rendition here the Judenhut of the Jew on the right, the Jewish hat that we spoke about in last week's episode, which was on the Jewish badge. The massacres were so horrific that, in fact, many Jews decided that it was preferable to even kill themselves and their children rather than be subjected to formal conversion. Very important turning point in Ashkenazic Jewish history. The Crusaders then went on after destroying the Rhineland. In fact, many of the Crusaders were not even close to the Rhineland. Many had traveled further south, but they went on to attack Jerusalem itself, to continue to massacre the populations there, creating a tremendous amount of enmity between Christians and Muslims, which persists to this day and, of course, has tremendous impact on contemporary Middle Eastern politics, where Western Europeans and Americans are regarded as modern-day crusaders by the peoples of the Middle East. The legacy for the Jews is extremely important. The massacres of the Rhineland were a defining moment in the mentality of Ashkenazic Jewry. Very important parts of the liturgy were constructed to memorialize the Crusades, including the Av HaRachamim, which is read in synagogues on Shabbat, and also many piyutim, which will be read on Tisha B'Av, commemorating these massacres. It caused, according to some historians, Ashkenazic Jewry to become much more inward-looking, much more insular, regarding outside society as much more toxic, in contrast perhaps to the Sephardic experience, which adopted more of an accommodationist approach to the outside world. But that's basically our anniversary for this week, the First Crusade, conquering Jerusalem in the year 1099 with tremendous ramification for world and Jewish history. Thank you very much for listening.